أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ثم ما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم. Quran Weekly. We've reached our 30th day, and I know this was pre-recorded, so I don't know if this 30th day is already going to be Eid or not. But regardless, I felt this last reminder should be my favorite surah of the Quran, Surah Al-Asr. And interestingly enough, it is in the 30th juz, so that's what we're doing today. And I think it's an appropriate conclusion to our series. Because if nothing else, we realized how quickly time goes by. I think all of you that are listening to this probably already know what Surah Al-Asr means. That Allah swears by time that is squeezing away from us, that is running out, that is dripping away so quickly we can't catch it. How quickly did the last 30 days go? How fast did they go? You look back, it feels like a week. We just started Ramadan, it's gone already. You know? Wal-Asr. And we lost that opportunity? Inna al-insana lafi khusr. No doubt about it, the human being is immersed, drowned in a state of loss. That's the reality of every human being. And the biggest loss we have is time. What we just lost is the time of Ramadan. What we're just about to lose is, you know, this blessed month, this opportunity to be forgiven. So now that you've learned what loss is like as a believer, don't let another day go by in procrastination. If you know what Surah Al-Asr is, it's the summary of the entire Qur'an. And if it is the summary of the entire Qur'an, then there's one thing you gotta get out of Surah Al-Asr, is respect for time. Fix your day. Go to sleep early. Wake up early. Pray Fajr on time. Pray with good attention. Don't waste your time. Don't be by yourself on your computer. Don't be up late at night, even if it's to watch Islamic videos. If you're a young man, try to get to the masjid for Isha. Try to get to the masjid for Fajr. If you can't do that, at least pray Isha and Fajr at home. Get other friends together and pray together. You know, human beings are continually and forever in loss. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Except those who believe. You know, whether we like it or not, we're all marching towards death. All of us. There's not a day goes by that I don't get closer to death. That my wife doesn't get closer to death, that my children don't get closer to death. All of us are on a march towards our mortality, our end, whether we like it or not. That loss is coming. One day has just been taken away from my life and I'll never get it back. One month has been taken away, I'll never get it back. I'm never going to get younger. It's not going to happen. I'm only going to get older. And the older I get, the closer I get to my final day on this earth. That is a fact. If you accept that fact, that all human beings are constantly losing their time. They're losing their opportunity. Because all we have in this world is time, right? Money, house, all of it. You're going to enjoy it in time, aren't you? If you don't have time, none of this matters. None of this matters. Somebody's told they're going to die in an hour. No wealth in the world matters. No food in the world, nothing matters now. Because all you have is an hour. So we have, if you've internalized this message of the Qur'an, that time is the biggest asset you have and you better make good use of it in this world, then you will have new respect for every day, for every hour, for every evening. There's not going to be a loose attitude towards weekends. There's not going to be any chance you get just wasted away sitting watching a screen, you know, play some video game or other things like that. You'll do productive things with your life. He says, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. The only people that are not going to lose out are people who believe. Who are the people who are going to end up in a life where there is no time restriction? Because if time is the biggest loss, who are the people who won't be losing out? People who believed. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. And the people who believed, and as a result of their belief, they did the few good things Allah asked them to do. الصَّالِحَاتِ, as I've mentioned in more detailed lectures, is just a handful of good deeds. It's not a lot. Allah is not asking for a lot. He's asking for a little. He's asking for a lot less from us throughout the year than he does in Ramadan. You're not going to do what you did in Ramadan the rest of the year. You wish you could, I wish I could, but we're not going to. And Allah is not asking us to either. He's asking a lot less. A lot less. So do it. As-salihat. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ. And they encourage each other, enjoin each other, counsel each other, advise each other, equally concerned. Tawasi actually means equal concern. Sawa would have been one dominating the other. Tawasa means we're both on equal footing. I know I'm not better than you, you know you're not better than me. We're looking out for each other. Find good company to keep your faith alive, to keep your value of time alive. Somebody to check on you. Hey, you didn't come for Isha yesterday. Where were you? Everything okay? Hey, I haven't seen you for a couple of days. Where you been? I'm worried about you. You're not coming to class. I haven't seen you. That's tawasi bil haqq. Enjoining each other, reminding each other why you're on this earth. How you're supposed to have a good life in this world without ever forgetting your purpose. Wa tawasaw bis sabr. And when these distractions come and these temptations come and these trials come in life, you got to hold on to your faith. Because sabr is not just over difficulty. Sabr is also over temptations. Sabr is also over distractions. You got to hold yourself back from indulging. You're going to have that real self-discipline. If you don't have it, you're not going to be able to survive this challenge. This is the beginning of our new life. All of us are confident today that Allah, because of our efforts in Ramadan and our sincere dua and the tears that we've shed, has given us a new start. We have to believe that. لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. And from here on out, we understand the value of time and we're really going to make the most of our lives. That's what we're going to do. You're going to make a schedule. You're going to see when are you going to memorize Quran? When are you going to learn to recite better? How are you going to wake up for prayers and make sure you have time for prayers? If you're a college student, how are you going to register for courses that don't conflict with Jummah time? That you're able to find time for every single prayer without messing up? You know, how are you going to find the courage to tell your employer that I need a prayer break? Take care of Salat first. Salat is the ultimate reminder of the value of time. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. The Salat on the believer is a law that keeps his time. If Asr is important to us, then Salat is important to us. You know? You have to keep track of that. You have to be on top of it. Those of you that are young, that are just in college or high school, and if you find yourself having a lot of free time, either fill it up with memorization of Quran or fill it up by getting a job. Do something with your time that's productive. Don't waste your time. It is free time that destroys most people's faith. There's nothing else. It's free time. It's that free time that goes into dating. It's that free time that goes into clubbing. It's that free time that goes into drugs. It's free time. If you're weak, don't give yourself free time. Keep yourself busy. And keep asking Allah for help. And I pray that Allah grants all of you good company, good judgment, wisdom, strength of character, that Allah helps you fight your temptations. Allah removes you from the people who are bringing you to sin, who are taking you into sin, and gives you company of people that make you better and better and better human beings. And eventually Allah makes you strong enough that other people come to Allah because of you. That's what you want to be. You want to be the people who do tawasi bil haqq, who do tawasi bil sabr. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us of them. And may Allah not make us of those who are in loss, rather make us of the exception. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim, wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikr al-Hakim. Please make dua for myself and my family for putting this series together. I certainly benefit from studying Qur'an, and even talking about it is a reminder to myself. And I hope you benefited from this reminder. And the only thing I ask in exchange is that you guys make lots and lots and lots of sincere dua for your brother, and ask Allah to forgive my mistakes. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.